So now we've selected the wood, like we've selected our plan, how we are going to go forward with this particular project, everything. Now we have selected the wood, and I've told you mostly you have to select the hardwood, and then the moisture meter. Everything is taken care of. Once you know this particular wood I want, now it is the time to prepare the wood. I will start with the preparation part. So preparation part begins with the cutting of the wood, obviously. When you select a wood, it won't be already cut. It will be in the shape of a log. Mostly when you go to a mill, it will be, if you can find a, if there is a piece of wood lying here and there with your friends or with the mill people, well and good. But generally you have to buy logs. You have to cut your wood from the logs. So that is the reason why you have to understand what kind of wood you are looking for, what kind of texture it is. So this is an entire different topics, in detail topic, which obviously there is a separate total course on individually on wood alone. So what is the exactly everything? So that is, so all these other things, they are like all other, they are major topics there, major courses there. So once you know this is the wood that I've selected, this is kind of wood I want, everything. Now you know. Even the most important thing is the color also of the wood also. When you're selecting the wood also, you have to first of all understand what color it will become. Sometimes, you know, there are a lot of other small details also even in wood also. Because sometimes it appears light color, and when you're done with your project, it just changes the color, it becomes darker. Sometimes it is white, so you have to understand which wood you are looking for. Like there are, if you are looking for something in black or something in golden or something in blue, there are different kinds of woods that you have to know, that you have to understand. So that will come with experience, and you have to have a knowledge of this also. So like now you have selected the wood now. Once you have selected the wood, it will be in the form of a log. So now what you have to do, straightforward general thing is, you have to cut it in slices. Because now the table which we prepared, we'll be preparing, those will be slices, which will be in a straight form. Like you can, that is up to your plan, in whatever shape that you are doing, one, two or three or however. Like I'll give you an example here. Like this is a small example. This is a tray that we are doing, tray. So now this is a wood which is already cut out of a log, thin wood. And then now there will be a epoxy pour here. So this will be entirely a resin. So after the finishing and all, this will be a tray. So in that way, maybe you will be making in whatever shape that you will be desiring, you'll be having a plan. So maybe you'll be of an entire wood you'll be making, or you'll be having three parts of woods, or however. So the basic thing is, first of all, you have to cut the wood. So cutting the wood is in the mill. When you buy a log of wood, you have to cut it through them. They'll be cutting it to you and giving it to you. They'll not just give you the log. So when you're cutting the log, you'll be knowing what thickness you are looking for. You have to understand what thickness you are looking for. If you are looking for 2 inches of thickness, 2 inches of thickness, so you have to cut accordingly. But make sure when you, if your project is in your mind, if the project is of 2 inches thickness, you have to always cut a slight, everything that we'll be doing, it should be like slightly higher than whatever your desired thing is. Even when you do the mold also, when you're doing the mold also, it should be slightly bigger than your desired shape. Even the thickness now, if you are doing a certain thickness of wood, certain thickness of a project, it should be always a bit higher, because there is a lot of wastage also. Lot of cleaning and all, there will be a lot of wastage. At least in wood, at least there will be, after the selection of the wood, what you will be doing, everything, there will be at least 20% of wastage. So if you are desiring to make a certain size, and if you just have in mind that this size is enough for us to get a certain table done, so that will always keep in mind. The end parts, they are always soft. They are always soft, and they will be wasted when you will be cleaning it up. So always remember that if you are doing a certain size, even the selection of the wood or selection of the lock should be slightly bigger than your desired shape, because it will always at least 20% of the wastage or even more. There will be so much wastage, because there are end parts that you will have to clean everything, and sanding and all. Even when you are doing the project also, there will be a lot of sandings, everything. So the thickness will obviously gradually decrease. Everything, there will be a lot of cutting also during the end part also. So everything will decrease. So when you do your project, you always remember in everything, even in, as I told you, making the mold also, certain size of mold, if you are making this and that, you have to always remember, you have to have the mold should be, everything should be a slight bigger than your desired thing, but there is a lot of wastage. It should not be accurate. If you are looking for some 6 feet table, it should not be exactly 6 feet. It should be 6 feet 2 inches long. So there should be something to work on. It should not be accurate on that. Even when you are building a mold, the mold should be slightly bigger than your actual size. So keeping that in mind, when you are cutting the wood also, the thickness, when you are cutting the thickness, it should be slightly thicker than 2 inches. Or 1 inches or 1.5 inches, whatever thickness that you desire, it should be slightly higher, slightly more than your desired thickness. So that is the cutting part. The log will be then cut into strips, into this shape. It will be cut like that. So it should be whatever your desired thickness is, it should be a bit higher than that, a bit higher than whatever that your desire is. So once that is cut, once the cutting part is done, so the next part is you have to clean the wood. Once the cutting is done, it will be just raw. It will be just from the, it is just like getting it from the forest. So it will be raw. There will be a lot of particles, a lot of insects, a lot of foreign bodies inside it. Because that log was kept there for a certain time, and there will be a lot of unwanted guests or termite or even snakes inside. So you have to take care of that also. There will be a lot of other, at least there will be a lot of mud, lot of like small unwanted particles or soft tissues inside that you will have to get rid of. So this part is cleaning of the wood part. So cleaning of the wood is, this is a wood, and there will be, the shape will be obviously not desired shape, when the end will be not desired. So always remember, you have to check for the soft tissues. There will be soft tissues everywhere. So then you have to just get tools like your chisel and just check for the soft part. There will be a lot of soft tissues here and there. Like here you can see, this is softness here. So whatever the softness that you encounter, you have to just get rid of it. At the end also, mostly at the end, there will be a lot of, here also see, this is a soft part now. You have to get rid of this softness. Your wood will be much thicker than this. So then you have to get rid of it manually. You have to get rid of it. It will just go away. Just use your chisel or whatever desired tool that you will be using. It'll just experience, you will come to know. But chisel is a good thing, that we use chisel. With chisel, you have to just as much as possible, you have to get rid of the soft tissues or the dust particles, everything which is at the end. Or even on the surface, you just have to check if the surface is okay. If the surface is soft, even for the hardwood, there will be certain places where it will be soft. So that softness we have to just, as far as possible, get rid of. You can use your hammer also. Like if it is tough to go, some it will be soft, but it will be tough to get rid of. So use a hammer. See, with hammer, you just have to just get rid of. Just the way you imagine you are doing a carving on your wood. So just get rid as much as possible until the hard part is achieved. Until it is hard, though it will be soft. So until you reach the hardest part of your wood, that is aged, that is cured, and this was a soft part which is usually at the end of the tree. The interior is always tough. The exterior, the skin and all, there will be the skin of the tree, the wood also. So that will be obviously soft, and that will carry a lot of moisture. So it is a contradictory thing that with the moisture meter also, sometimes when you check it, so it will, maybe it will show you a different reading, because exterior it will be obviously moist. So that is the reason why you cannot judge according to the, when you look at it, you cannot judge whether it is aged or not. Well, sometimes, you know, when you keep it outside in the environment, there is dew, there is moisture, there is a lot of rain and stuff. So exterior, it is always, it is a cover. It will have moisture. But then you have to get rid of it, and the interior part, that is always, which is aged, that is always tough, and it is of less moisture. So that also you have to keep in mind. So the interior part will be tough, the interior will be tough, and it will be moisture free for hardwoods. So that is the reason why I am telling you to use the aged one, aged woods. For normally also for your thick wood, the normal age is anyway between 50 to 100 years. The age of the tree is, it is a aged tree. It takes a lot of time to get there, to get to a certain shape and size. So that is also there. So interior is very tough. It is extremely strong. And when you age, when you cut it down and you keep it for a long time, 2-3 months, so that moisture disappears. The moisture inside, it disappears. So that is the technical part. That is a gray area that you have to understand. This is not just white, black and white, as I always tell you. You have to use your intelligence also. It may not always show on your moisture meter, but then you have to understand what is the actual thing. So first of all, this soft part you have to get rid of using different tools, like I told you, chisels and all, and there will be a lot of holes or a lot of other stuff also. Then you can use your, you can get wire brushes here. Then some different tools, you have to just like use your tools, whatever is available here, to just get rid of the holes, and then just check for the termites and insects inside. Even we encountered snakes also, small snakes, spiders and whatever. There will be a lot of gas waiting for you inside. You have to actually like clean it. You have to, because now we are making it into a masterpiece. So now obviously we have to clean the entire thing. So that is the cleaning of the part. Cleaning part that we are, I tell you. Also, there is another thing that you may do. And this is a fire torch. This fire torch you have to get only because it has a lot of work in our project. Because it is used in getting rid of the bubbles and all. Without this, we cannot proceed with our projects. Because this is very important, this fire torch. So fire torch you have to get. Obviously, we'll be discussing all the equipments also gradually. So this fire torch you have to get. This fire torch is very important. After cleaning and all, after cleaning the your wood, all everything, and there will be difficult areas that might be not reached. It might be not reached that much. So the second but more precaution is that you have to just fire your wood. Fire entire wood. Just use fire and just fire the entire wood. Even in the holes which you thought you have reached, but just try to fire that thing. Don't worry, it will not burn. Just quickly fire it, because sometimes this insect, sometimes all these other small termites and all, they don't come out easily. They are very stubborn. Once you apply the fire also, then they just come out. So that is another thing, because experientially we know. Once we also encountered this gas during the pouring time. During the pouring time, when it was like really, we did the pour and it was curing, that time something came out and it just stuck in there. And we didn't even realize until and unless the entire project was done. So it's like that. It may not show up. It may not straightforward when you even clean up the surface and all. You should be extremely careful. You have to like minutely observe everything. And then the thing is, you have to actually you have to fire the entire wood. Just fire it entire wood, because of the termite whatever insect. Secondly, if there is some moisture there, so it will just go away with the fire and all. It will just go away. When I say fire, don't just fire. It is just like apply heat, slight heat you have to apply. That is for reasons, for moisture also. Moisture will also go, and plus for the other things also. So this is the cleaning part.